Today we're going to be going over how to take care of prayer plants. This includes the family of the Marantas and the Calatheas. I have a Maranta right here, and as you can see, the leaves, they kind of fold in. This is where they get their name, because their leaves will kind of fold in like hands in prayer, and then during the night they will fold back out. And so it's kind of a fun little plant that has a lot of movement with it if you notice it at different times of the day. So to start off, what kind of lighting needs do prayer plants have? They do prefer bright and direct sunlight. They can have less light than that, although they will not grow as fastly or as well. Most tropical indoor houseplants do prefer bright and direct sunlight for best growing capabilities. They can tolerate short periods in the sun, although if they get too much direct sunlight, it can cause their leaves to have burnt, crispy edges on them, which we don't want, so just make sure they aren't getting very much direct sunlight, if any at all. Generally, they don't do well in places with fluctuating temperatures, such as a windowsill or a doorway. They more like it as just a constant temperature. They do like humidity, so a bathroom, if it has good lighting, it will do well there. And also, another reason why your plant might get crispy edges along the edge of the leaves, not just because of being in too much sun, but it could also be to not enough humidity. So if you notice that, one easy way to get it back to being healthy and not having those leaves have burnt crispy edges is to get a pebble tray. That's just a tray full of water and pebbles, and it can kind of raise the humidity around your plant. Spraying it with a spray gun will raise the humidity for maybe a minute or less, but it will not last. So I recommend using a pebble tray as a lasting and easy way to do it if you don't have a top grade humidifier in your home. And going along with water, they do like to have moist soil. So when you're watering it, this is what I do. I fill the soil. If it feels moist, I don't bother watering it. If it's feeling dry, then I will go ahead and water it. Sometimes there can be dry pockets of soil, and you will notice that your leaves may get really limp. And you can fix this by aerating your soil. Just get a pencil or a crochet hook or just something that's pokey but won't damage your plant, and just poke it in there, create some holes, water it again, and that will kind of get rid of those dry pockets of soil. Also with water, using distilled, filtered, or rainwater is best for these guys. I'll be honest, I've only used tap water for him right here, but over time, using tap water can build up and they can get leaf spots. It's just discolored spots on the leaves, and it could be from you using tap water over a large amount of time. Different chemicals can build up in the soil and can affect it. So if you are willing, you know, to use your filtered water or your rainwater, this guy will prefer it. As far as soil goes, using a well-draining soil works best. So you can just use potting mix found at the hardware store. That's what I have this guy in. You could also use succulent mix if you'd really like to. Just something that's not gonna keep the water from moving, like a clay type of soil would. And you want somewhere for the water to go to. I have mine just in a bigger pot so that water can drain out and I can dump this back into the sink if there is sitting water in here. Because you do not want your prayer plant just sitting in sitting water. That can cause root rot and kill your entire plant. We don't want that. All right, and if you're wondering if your prayer plant needs to be repotted, you can figure that out once roots start to come out of the bottom of your pot. You can see mine doesn't have any, so it's probably good. The roots are actually quite shallow, and so they don't need to be repotted very often. I would say once you start seeing roots come out in the bottom though, go ahead and get a pot that's only about 1 to 2 inches bigger. You don't want to go for a huge pot. It actually just creates a really wet environment with soil with no roots in it. So it's just wet soil sitting there, and that can damage your plant. So just go 1 to 2 inches bigger if you are needing to repot your prayer plant. All right, when it comes to fertilizing your prayer plant, I like to use a 10-15-10 mix. I don't know if you can see those numbers, they're kind of small, but that refers to the nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium ratios of active ingredients within this fertilizer. So those are three of the main macronutrients that your plant needs. And I have a whole video going into that if you really want to dive into all of that. And I'll include the link for any products I'm showing on here just so to make it easier for you guys. But this is just a liquid fertilizer that I use on my prayer plant when it's growing season. So that's generally in the spring and summer months is when it's growing more just because of extended hours of sunlight. And you will be fertilizing it maybe 3 to 4 times in ideal conditions. If it's in a lower lip place and it's not growing as much, you don't need to fertilize it as much. But if it's growing well, I would aim for 3 to 4 times during the spring and summer months. Your prayer plant can be susceptible to thrips, spider mites, or scale simply because they have a lot of just like nooks and crannies for these guys to hide in and make a home. So when I'm dealing with that sort of thing, I first will go and use neem oil. And this is just a spray on one that I have. Again, I'll include the link down below. And this really helps with any sort of pest, especially spider mites and thrips. As far as scale, that's something that kind of needs to be manually removed for the most part. You can kind of brush them off to a garbage somewhere where you won't see them again. But my go-to solution would be to use neem oil if you do find any pests on your prayer plant. When it comes to propagating a prayer plant, they're actually very easy to propagate. So all you need to do when propagating one, you will simply take a cutting off of your plant and your plant will have nodes on it. And I have one right here that I propagated probably 4 weeks ago or so. I simply took a cutting and put it in water and you can see the roots are growing really well in here in this little bottle. I'm going to be taking it out soon and putting into a new pot where it can grow as a separate plant. And you can take a few cuttings and put a few cuttings in a pot to make a more full plant, but it does propagate very easily, which I love. You can't complain about that, right? Also, as another note, calatheas, which are also considered prayer plants, they can be divided as well as using a cutting. So when I say it can be divided, I simply mean that you can go in and cut the root ball of the plant in half of a calathea and place half of it into a pot, the other half into another pot. Just because this plant is rhizomatous, that means it has underground roots and they can be broken apart and separated and you can propagate it that way. If you notice that you ever get older leaves that are turning yellow, that's pretty normal. It happens on this plant. Once it's fully dead, you can simply cut it off and throw it away. If it is a new leaf, like one of these little guys down here, and it's going yellow, that could be a sign of a pest. So make sure you just get in there and see if anything is living around your prayer plant and causing problems, and so that you can take the steps necessary to get rid of them. And lastly, if you notice a leaf is yellowing and the base of the leaf, so that would be like right here on the base or even lower down, if it's turning black, that could be a sign of overwatering and your plant is starting to decay. So just make sure you cut back on watering, make sure there's no sitting water in the pot that it's in, and make sure not to water it too much going forward. As far as cleaning your prayer plant, they kind of have fuzzy leaves. So it's not something you can spray down and just wash away. What I use is this little microfiber cloth right here, and I kind of just dust them off. You can get a good amount of dust away from the leaf just by doing this very gently. You don't really want to scrub it and harm those hairs on the leaves because they are very fine. And that is it. That is how you care for your prayer plant. If you have a question, feel free to comment down below. I will try and answer them and help you guys out with caring for your prayer plants. And again, if you haven't already, please subscribe. It not only supports this channel, but also supports my family, and I really appreciate it. I'm always trying to come out with stuff for houseplant owners and to help you have happy and healthy houseplants.